Welcome to Board Online, Board Offline. Today we'll be unboxing Frosthaven. That's right, Frosthaven, not the Frosthaven organizer from Folded Space. But I wanted to point this out first. As it turns out, Folded Space was nice enough to send me a copy of this insert, as well as the map archive here. What is kind of funny about it is that I forgot that 2 years ago, or however long ago it was, that I backed Frosthaven. I think actually was a late backer, but whenever I backed it, I knew back then that I wanted a Folded Space insert, and I actually purchased one and completely forgot that I had done so. So Folded Space sent me one of these. I have an extra one because I purchased one a couple years back. And so I checked with Folded Space and they want me to give this one away to someone on the channel. So the giveaway will not be in this video. I'm going to build this insert, and then I will have a video showing the insert, showing it built out, and in that video, I will give it away. It probably will be maybe a week from now, so just stay tuned to the channel and come back for that video, and you'll have your chance to win a insert for Frosthaven from Folded Space. Okay, so no joke, I think I might have tweaked my back when I just picked this up off the floor. I think you can hear me grunting in pain. Oh, Jesus. Lift with your legs, not with your back, when you pick up Frosthaven. Okay, this is Frosthaven. We are going to get right into this momentarily. Let's see, you know, I to this day don't know that I know what the bottom of the Gloomhaven box looks like, because once you unbox it and get it organized, you can't flip it over anymore. So let's look at the back of the Frosthaven box. Oh God, it's messing up the table. Guys, this game is really heavy. Okay. Whew. All right, well, look at this thing. So that's what the bottom of a Frosthaven box looks like. Exclusive to this channel. You see it right here for the first time. No one else has ever shown you this, the bottom of a Frosthaven box. Let's go on and unseal it while we're back here. Oh, look at this. 138 scenarios, 17 playable classes, 64 different enemy types, 64 different enemy types, 2,500 cards, evolving map board, 18 detailed plastic miniatures. So that must mean one of these classes has two miniatures, kind of like in Gloomhaven. 1-4 players, 30 minutes a player, ages 14 plus. All right, so we are going to get into Frosthaven. Before we do that, I want to mention our sponsor, StoneValleyGames.com. StoneValleyGames.com is run by Eric and Wendy, and it is your friendly, distant game store with all kinds of fantastic stuff over there. You absolutely need to go check it out. If you are in the military and you're stationed overseas and you have an AA, AE, or AP address, they'll ship to you for free. If you currently live, whether or not you're in the military, in the continental United States, and you order over $100 worth of stuff, or I believe it's $100 or more, stuff from them, they will ship to you for free. And if you are a return customer, they have a loyalty program as well. Lots of great stuff going on over there. They've got the old hotness, the new classics, the new hotness, the old classics, all of that good stuff. Go check them out. StoneValleyGames.com. There is a link in the description below. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Welcome to Frosthaven. Stop, read this before you do anything else. There is a significant number of components in this game box, and it's important to make sure they are organized before your first game. This guide will show you how to organize everything so that you can start playing as quickly as possible. Yes, but I am not going to organize it quite this way, I don't believe. Oh my God, look at that. You know, if Frosthaven can make this sort of a guide, everyone can do it. Everyone can do it. This is so helpful when you have a game that has anything more than just a few components. Anyway, all right, well, we will try to keep things relatively organized as we go through it. Here is the rule book. Now, I do have this already scripted, so I will be able to start working on instructional videos very soon. Here are the starting classes, the banner spear. Oh, I like that they mention low complexity and high complexity. So banner spear, drifter, Bone Shaper. Let's read this whole thing. Banner Spear, low complexity, natural leader and protector with powerful attacks that require proper positioning. Drifter, low complexity, jack of all trades with great stamina to fill any role you need. Bone Shaper, medium complexity, summoner of the undead who sacrifices their health to create and heal allies. Deathwalker, medium complexity, manipulator of dead spirits who uses death as fuel for their abilities. Blinkblade, high complexity, powerful melee fighter who is able to quickly zip in and out of combat. And Geminate, high complexity, insect swarm with two separate forms that allow for switching between melee and ranged attacks. All right, and so then we've got... So the credits, the appendix. Okay. 71 pages. All right. 71 pages of stuff here. These are actually variants, actually. I believe, yeah, game variants. So here, 68 pages of stuff, of rules to get through. All right. There's our first locked item here. There was something in Gloomhaven called like the town records or something like that. So imagine that might be similar. Here is the section book. Section book. Yeah, this I believe is something that you don't look at until you're instructed to, if I remember correctly, maybe. The scenario book here, of course, has all the scenarios in it. I like that it's spiral bound. That's nice. A lot more colorful this time around, too. Ton of stuff, of course. What did we say? 137 scenarios or something like that? The campaign sheet is way more involved this time around than last time. I mean, it's a full-size A4 page here. I'm glad they give you lots of them. I mean, so there's about 10 of them in there for 10 different campaigns if you go through it that many times. Let's just keep working down this side over here. Here is the Frosthaven, the northern coast. We've got the Radiant Forest over here. Here's Frosthaven, this little tiny place over here. We got the Imperial Mountains, the Frozen Pass, Copperneck Mountains, Whitefire Woods, Crystal Fields. This map is so cool. Like, it is... It looks like the Gloomhaven map was created by a cartographer who was just getting the hang of things, and now they have really gone above and beyond. Nice. So we've got a much larger look of the outpost of Frosthaven. Now, of course, that makes sense because you are actually going to be building buildings here and everything, purchasing buildings, building them up, defending Frosthaven from attacks and stuff. So this is really exciting stuff here. So we got stickers. There's enhancement stickers there. Some campaign stickers, map overlay stickers. It's quite a bit of stuff there. So in here's where you're building out some buildings. Logging camp. The logging camp keeps getting bigger. Mining camp keeps getting bigger. That's cool. Some additional defenses and stuff. Not sure. Oh, what was this? I remember talking about this in the rules. It was a few months back that I scripted it out, so we'll see. All right, so here's... I wonder if this is completely replaced by the folded space insert, or folded space takes this into account. But it is nice that they give you all this stuff, because the original Gloomhaven came with nothing really of substance for organization initially. Let's see, I'm going to move this. I really do want to try to keep this organized for now. So let's move this over here. Okay. All right, let's see what we got. What in the world? Look at all this unlockable stuff. I knew there was unlockable stuff. I just did not realize. Oh my god. I think we're getting into the punch boards down here. Did not realize there was this much of it. Oh, these are. Oh, that's right. This is how. This is the scenario tree. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Oh, yeah. See how it connects like that? See those arrows up there at the top? Is this all still? No. Yeah, we're definitely getting down into punch boards. Okay. I mean, you can see there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of these flowchart sheets. Okay. We got just an absurd number of punch boards here. Let's see. Oh, look at that. That's kind of nice. Oh, my Lord. I'm going to break my finger. Okay. Okay. So, there is clearly... Let's turn this a little bit. Nah. Clearly a lot more color this time around. You can see we've got, you know, and more detail as well. That's kind of cool. So these are obviously the condition tokens, and this is a new condition. I can't remember what it's called. A couple of new conditions we're seeing here. Like doors and stuff like that. Here are some of the different enemies you might end up fighting. Oh, look at that. That just punches right out. I love that. All the different names. I can't remember if these are here just for organizational purposes or what, but here we go. We're getting into the actual enemies here. Lots of guys that look familiar. I mean, there these guys here, these cannons, but some of these guys are definitely new to Frosthaven. These two guys down here are from Gloomhaven, but this looks new. Same thing. All right, so these guys are Gloomhaven. The skeletons, these guys, and the cannons, but then all of that looks new. I'm loving all the little details on this terrain too, by the way. The spears laying around. It just has such a good feel to it. God, these guys, the oozes hate those guys. These guys are pretty obnoxious too. The deep terror. Well, we're gonna have to deal with the actual polar bear. That's gonna probably be terrifying. These look very similar to something from Gloomhaven, but the forest imps or forest sprites or something like that, but probably, you know, we're up in the north, the great white north now, or south. I believe Frosthaven's the north of Gloomhaven. So obviously that could be probably something different, maybe related. This guy looks terrifying. Look how big that guy is. And what in the world is this over here? So much to explore. This guy got a sling. Looks like he's got a sling and Wolverine claws right there. No idea what in the world that is. They're not insects, so it's not one of the harrowers. It's something else. But definitely. All right. Okay, so now we're down into. Does this have stuff under it? Uh-oh. It does. We gotta be careful with that. Okay, so here are your different classes. Let's see, I can't remember which ones are unlocked to begin with. I buried the instruction manual. Can I get to it? Let's take a look at the Bone Shaper. This one. All right. Oh, yeah. Okay. See, there's no steel on this one, but I bet if we look at one of these, see, the ones that are not starter classes have seals on them. Oh, I love that color. I think the Bone Shaper might be my first one that I use. There's a lot of cards here, but I guess maybe that's the right amount. I mean, let's see what the Bone Shaper's starting hand. Let's pull all this out. Whoa, lots of extra stuff there. That's cool. So, oh my gosh, this already has way more stuff on it. So it gives you class notes to give you an idea of how to play them. That's really cool. Hand size is 12. Okay, so that is a pretty large hand. Look at all these notes. I wonder if they do that for the classes that are beyond the starter classes. But that's really cool. And then this has, I'm sure, maybe not. Maybe they do this for all of them. But look right here. Summon gives you the page, the reference in the rule book. That is very cool. Very good stuff. Oh, and look, complexity back here as well. Not only gives you the complexity here, elemental affinities you can expect to deal with. Retirement, of course, is here. But then it gives you some graphs. Oh, my gosh. They have done so much. Graphs to show you what you can expect from this one. Very high defense, very low mobility and control. That, wow, just so cool. Let's put. Oh, and then when you, it actually shows a picture of the creature you're summoning as well. The graphic design is definitely improved here from Gloomhaven. And Gloomhaven, you know, did a great job with the graphic design for so much complexity, but they have definitely gone farther here. All right, so. All right, and there is the card for this particular class. These are all the perks here, the resource. See, there's just so much new and cool stuff here. So the cards, we're gonna basically leave alone. I'm not going to risk pulling these out and them exploding everywhere. Plus, you know, to a certain extent, these are could be considered spoilers, and I'm gonna minimize the chance of that. I like that they give you these the dividers for your active summer road events. You have seasons in this game too, which is so cool. Available town guard. Here's some more cards down here that we'll have to get into. These are obviously we've got some. These are possibly all items. Look at the spyglass. During your attack ability, gain advantage on one attack. Yeah, so just a bunch of other stuff here that we're not going to necessarily get all into. What? I saw an appendix back here that showed the different. These are loot cards, okay. Those are your battle goals. What is that? Challenge cards. Let's see here. So loot cards. So it just gives you whatever that is. But then battle goals can be stuff like accountant. Have 0 cards in your hand each time you rest. And then we've got this. Armor testing. Whenever any character suffers damage, I guess, from an attack that is not reduced by a shield. Can't remember where that is. That's added to the attack. Okay. 55 town guard cards. There are some attack modifier cards, some more of those. Oh, look at all of those bags. I mean, I'll say this, they definitely set you up better in the base game than they, or just like the way it comes, is set up way better than it was when it was Gloomhaven. It was really just an empty box for the most part. All right, so there's some road events. Those probably are summer road events, winter road events, outpost events, and summer outpost events and winter outpost events. All right, so we are going to go down one level deeper here, see what we got. All right, so here are, of course, your health and experience point trackers. Here are, that's interesting. Why do you have damage on the back, but this is the side where you would actually keep the damage? Here are all your enemies in here. You got Fracture of the Deep. That sounds terrible. Chaos Demon also sounds just awful. So many envelopes here. Come on. I mean, look at this. Just a ton of envelopes that are going to get opened at random times. That is a very thick envelope right there. Let's take a look at our, what was it, bone, whatever, bone something, bone shaper, the bone shaper. There she is. That is a cool looking mini right there. Very nice. Let's take a look at each of the starting ones real quick. So that was the Bone Shaper, Banner Spear, right here. Oh, look at that. This is interesting. Why? I guess this one is more fragile. Look at that. Huh. So that was Banner Spear. Let's look at the Drifter. Definitely higher quality minis, I think, than, I mean, like smaller little details and everything, than were in Gloomhaven. Deathwalker. This is the Blink Blade. Look at that little guy. And finally, the Geminate is. Which one? I'm looking right power right here. No? That's not it. Oh, right, it's the two minis right here. So that probably is the, oh, this is a harrower. Okay, yeah, because of the insect swarm. So this is probably the melee version. And let's see this one. Yep, that looks more like a ranged version. So cool. And that is everything that comes in Gloomhaven, Frosthaven. Be sure to come back. I will be bringing you an instructional video for this. And instructional video. I'll be bringing you an instructional series for Frosthaven. On top of that, I have an instructional series for Aeon Trespass coming. I'll be continuing my instructional series for Perdition's Mouth. I've got instructional series for Australia coming up. Lots of fantastic stuff coming up on the channel. Be sure to come back and check that all out. And until next time, for Board Online, Board Offline.